exercise starts. The deal was finalized, but the certificate required under the presser amendment was never issued by the White House in the wake of the Soviet pullout from Afghanistan. At one stage, American seemed to have gobbled up the money and the plans. In the wake of 9/11, to Washington showed no inclination to sell F-16 to Pakistan, in view perhaps of Indian sensitivity. The latest decision too does not visualize a direct sale from the United States. Instead, Washington would authorize Belgium to sell the planes to Pakistan after congressional approval. The sales are not a modest scale and posed no threat to any other country. Basically, they should be seen against the background of the threatening build up of India offensive weapons and the danger, as Pakistan has repeatedly pointed out. It wanted Washington to understand its concerns that flow from and arms imbalance in conventional weapons in South Asia, as pointed out by it time and again. Inferiority in conventional weapons would only increase Pakistan's reliance on its nuclear deterrence. These massive allocations for undertaking so many public sector development projects should be a matter of great satisfaction for those who have been pressing the government over the past 4 years to do something big and soon to arrest the declining investment rate and escalating unemployment level. Exercise starts. The deal was finalized, but the certificate required under the presser amendment was never issued by a White House in the wake of the Soviet pullout from Afghanistan. At one stage, Americans seemed to have gobbled up the money and the plans. In the wake of 9/11, to Washington showed no inclination to sell F-16 to Pakistan, in view perhaps of Indian sensitivity. The latest decision too does not visualize a direct sale from the United States. Instead, Washington would authorize Belgium to sell the planes to Pakistan after congressional approval. The sales are not a modest scale and posed no threat to any other country. Basically, they should not be seen against the background of the threatening build up of India offensive weapons and the danger, as Pakistan has repeatedly pointed out. It wanted Washington to understand its concerns that flow from and arms imbalance in conventional weapons in South Asia, as pointed out by it time and again. Inferiority in conventional weapons would only increase Pakistan's reliance on its nuclear deterrence. These massive allocation for undertaking so many public sector development projects should be a matter of great satisfaction for those who have been pressing the government over the past 4 years to do something big and soon to arrest the declining investment rate and escalating unemployment levels.